News 8's Weather on the 8s with meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
Just coming up on that 6:38 mark. You know, February was a warm month, about 4.5 degrees above the long-term averages. Let's go back, take a look at February. Here's how it stacked up. The highest temperature was back on the first of the month. We had that 61-degree mark. Hit near that 60 a couple of times, but it was the only 60. 19 was the coldest low, and that was the only teen the entire month. 2.12 inches of rain, a little below normal, but we were going into yesterday about 1.25 inches below normal, so we picked up a good deal of rain yesterday across the valley. Most of the rain's out of here for today, but it will be kind of a damp and dreary start. Sunshine returns, though, this afternoon. Should be a pretty decent afternoon. Well, the westerly wind gets us back above that 50 mark, clearing out, chilly tonight, down to the low to mid-30s, a little frosty for tomorrow morning, but then sunshine will start it out. We'll get back into the 50s. We'll say sunny to partly sunny. Well, I think some high clouds will start to filter out the sun later on this afternoon or tomorrow afternoon. A little bit of a breeze, too, but all in all, not too bad a day. There's a live look over Lebanon. Visibilities are improving a little bit, but still low gray overcast and 39 still in the Cedar City with 100% relative humidity. So you get the picture. There's some fog out there this morning. Watch for that. But temperatures not that far from 40 for most of us. Starting to pick up some 50s. Westminster, Maryland, 52 right now. Some of that milder air is going to try to push in, but kind of a damp and cool start. There is a little bit of rain, upper parts of the valley, maybe a few sprinkles crossing parts of northern Adams, York, and southern parts of Cumberland counties. You can see that just kind of drifting on through. It's kind of tailing behind the main storm, which is up here, up close to Buffalo now, and it's starting to pull away. You can see on the satellite view, drier air coming in from the south and west, and that's where our winds are coming from, the west, southwest. I do think that'll dry us out. It may take most of the morning to get rid of it, though, but I do think we'll eventually see that. The storm will start to pull away. High pressure will build in. That should start to clear it out a little bit. Then that high builds over us for a chilly night tonight. We'll turn our attention to a new storm forming out in the plains. This could, unfortunately, give them some more severe weather out in the Midwest and the plains as we head into tomorrow. We'll start it sunny and probably just see some high clouds ahead of this storm, but then a warm front comes through. Rain comes in tomorrow night and into the first part of Saturday, and we start Saturday pretty warm, but then chillier air comes in behind that system for the second half of the weekend. Let me show you the temperature. We start kind of cool and damp, recover today, back down in the 30s tonight, recover up into the 50s tomorrow. See all this warm air? That's what's aimed at us for Saturday morning ahead of the front. 60s maybe, the predictor's saying, then cooling it down behind the front. The second half of the weekend looks chilly, but a mild start to March, 50s the next few days. And again, it could even be near 60 before the rain comes to an end on Saturday, and that gusty northwest wind picks up. I don't think we're out of the 40s Monday and Tuesday, maybe, or Monday, Tuesday, and even Sunday. Sunday looks like a pretty chilly day with a gusty wind and even flurries around. Is this still winter? Wow. 50 degrees, though. I think we're back up into the 50s second half of next week. I do really think the end of next week really starts warming up.
All right. Okay. You like that?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah.
Thanks, Joe.